Today is the autumnal equinox, where the dark minutes pretty much match the light minutes in the day. We're starting to turn from the heat of summer into the coolness of winter. So today's practice will be reflective of that. We'll have some yang elements, some very fiery movement parts of the practice, as well as some yin elements, some cooling still elements to the practice. So let's get started. Start on your back. And we'll start with a little bit of movement today. Bend your knees, put your hands next to your hips, and with your inhale, stretch your arms up and above your head. And move with your breath here. Exhale, hands next to your hips. Inhale, fill your arms up. And exhale, hands next to your hips. One more time, inhale, fill your arms up. And exhale, hands down. Float your right leg up to the sky. Point your toes and exhale. Lower your heel to hover above the floor. Inhale, flex up through the sole of your foot. Point your toes, exhale, lower your heel. Flex your foot, inhale. Point your toes, exhale. Flex your foot, inhale. And draw your knee to your chest, exhale. Place your foot on the earth, flex up through the left foot, take a breath. Point your toes, slowly lower. Flex your foot, inhale. Point your toes, exhale. Flex your foot, inhale. Point your toes, exhale. Flex your foot, inhale. Hug your knee in and exhale. Hug both knees in and begin to rock yourself to an easy seat. Take a moment to close your eyes, draw your hands to your heart. Bring to mind the blessings of the summer. Gratitude for what has been. And take a moment to notice if there's something that needs to be shed, needs to be let go of as we move into the season of winter. Bow your head to your heart, thumbs to your third eye. And return your thumbs to heart center. Open your arms nice and wide, turn your thumbs back, palms up. Roll your shoulders back, and as you exhale, turn your palms down, thumbs all the way back and around, slate that forward. Inhale, lift your thumbs, lift your heart. Turn your thumbs back, your palms up, and wind it all the way back around so the palms again turn up with a slate that in. Inhale, reach all the way up. And exhale, bring it all the way back down. Bring your palms back up, heart lifts, reach your arms up, and fold your hands into your heart. Bring yourself into table on your mat. Find a stable spine, draw your belly in and up, and extend back through your left leg. Exhale, curl in. Inhale, extend. Open your toes out, and bring your knee towards your tricep. Take your leg across to the right side of your mat. We'll do that again. Float your leg back, knee into navel. Extend straight back, toes turn out. Tap the top of your tricep. Take it all the way back and around. Bring your knee back to center. Switch to the right side. Take your leg straight back. Curl in, knee to nose. Extend back, turn your toes out. Tap the top of your right tricep. Take it all the way back and around for a twist. Bring everything back to center. Find your first downward facing dog. Shift your hands forward. Curl your toes, lift your knees. And send your body nice and long from hands to sit bones. Let your ears be right between your arms. Bend and stretch your legs a few times. And begin to slowly tiptoe your feet to your hands. Walk your hands slightly forward, heel toe your feet a little bit wider, rise up off the heels of your feet, and slowly return your heels, lift the balls and toes of your feet. Spine stays at the half lift. Walk your fingers forward, lift your heels. Fingers slightly back, lift the balls and toes of your feet. We'll do that one more time. Lift your heels. Soft knees, and reach back again, soft knees, lift the balls and toes of your feet. Slowly fold in, soften your knees, shake your head up. Hands to your waist and root to rise all the way up. When you turn forward, interlace your hands, press forward, plug in, and stretch up. Take a breath in here. Bend your elbows, slight bend to the knees, and press to the left. Bend elbows and knees and press straight up again. One more time, bend elbows and knees and stretch to the right. Bend elbows and knees and press up with your heart. Fold your hands to your heart. Take an easy breath in and an easy breath out. Reach your arms all the way up. Wide wings, forward fold. Halfway lift, inhale, let it go, exhale. Step back, plank pose. Knees, chest, and chin to the earth. Lift your heart anchor into your toes, cobra pose or sphinx pose. Exhale to your dog pose. Right leg rises, three-legged dog. Take a long breath in. Curl and step through, low lunge, drop your back knee to the mat, bring your hands to your thigh and settle in. Reach your arms all the way up, take a breath. Hands come down, hips go back, half Hanuman. You can bring blocks in for this pose as well, underneath your hands. With your next breath, bend your knee one more time, rise up. Exhale, hands down, step to plank. Knees, chest, chin, chaturanga, inhale. Exhale, dog pose. Left leg rises, three-legged dog. Step between your hands, low lunge, right knee drops down, rise with your breath. Exhale, hands down, hips go back, half Hanuman. Deep breath here, again, blocks might be necessary, full breath out. Bend into your knee, again, lunge, rise. Exhale, hands down, step forward, forward bend. Halfway lift, inhale. Let it go, exhale. Root down, rise all the way up. Thumbs to the heart. Inhale, rise. Exhale, fold. Half lift, inhale. Step back, right foot, right knee drops down, low lunge. Rise with your breath. Exhale, hands down, hips back, half Hanuman. Bend your knee, lift your right knee, full lunge, rise. Soften, lift. Hands go down, step back, plank pose. Flow through. Back bend of choice. Downward facing dog. Up on your tiptoes, knees bend, step hop, float, forward fold. Rise with your breath, inhale. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, reach wide up. Bend your knee, rise, lift your heart. Exhale, hands down, step back, plank. Knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga to flow to your back bend. Exhale to your dog pose. Up on your tiptoes, knees bend, hop wide, squat pose. Interlace your hands, begin to press straight up again. Exhale, come back down to squat. Inhale, press up and to the right. Exhale to squat. Inhale, press up and to the left. Exhale to squat. And one more time, rise and lift. Exhale, hands to heart. Heel toe your feet back to center. Reach your arms up and fold. Exhale. Half lift, inhale. And let it go. Step back, plank. Flow through or meet me in dog. Right leg rises, three-legged dog. Bend, twist, and open. Maybe circle your toes. Extend your legs, square your hips, curl into warrior two. Back heel comes down, rise with your breath. Reverse that warrior. Extended side angle. Back hand reaches forward, squeeze your feet strongly together. Reverse your triangle. Triangle pose. Deep breath here. And a full breath out. Bend your knee, plant your fingertips to the inside of your right foot. Place your left hand at your sacrum and roll your heart open. Resist elbow and knee. Perhaps take this right hand underneath your leg and reach for your sit bone. Maybe you can clasp hands and roll your heart open. And maybe staying here is the best place for you today. Big reverse warrior, let go of the mind. Bend your knee. Cartwheel down, step up. Three-legged plank, float that right foot or bend. Maybe flow through and maybe not. Downward facing dog on an exhale. Left leg rises, bend, twist, open. Maybe circle those toes in the air. Extend your legs, square your hips, warrior two. Rise, settle, and reverse that warrior. Extended side angle, elbow to thigh, right hand reaches forward, deep breath. Full exhale. Rise and reverse that triangle. Exhale, triangle pose. Get bright from your left hand to your right, bright from waist to armpits. Bend your knee, plant your fingertips on the inside of the left arch. Bring your right heel and hand to the sacrum. Roll your arms and your heart open and resist your left knee with your left elbow. Stay here. Or perhaps take that left hand underneath you, reaching for your sit bone. Or maybe bind the arms together and roll your chest open. Big reverse warrior. Soften into that knee. Cartwheel your hands down. Step back to plank pose and flow through. Knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Making your way back to a dog pose. Lift up to your tiptoes. Imagine that big pile of leaves between your hands. And hop or step forward. Rise with your breath, inhale, hands to heart, exhale. take a pose called Bird of Paradise today. If you have blocks and you'd like to put one foot on a stack of blocks, you're more than welcome to do that. Otherwise, you can follow along with me. Lift and spread your toes on that left foot. If you have a stack of blocks and you want to put the ball of the right foot up on that stack of blocks, by all means do that. Otherwise, lift up off that right heel. Begin to bring your right fingertips down to the inside of your foot, much like we just did in that extended side angle. Bring the heel of your left hand around to your sacrum. So maybe this is where you stay, stretching your chest forward and your tail feathers back. Perhaps you can take that right hand around to your sit bone. Maybe bind your hands and paws there, and then stretching your forward tail back. Perhaps you can lift and spread your toes, hug your arm around your thigh and around your outer hip with the hands. Take your drishti to the floor and let your drishti follow the floor as you lift that right leg up for Bird of Paradise. Extend your spine. Get tall, maybe lengthen your right leg. A little or a lot. It's about as far as I can go today. Keep wrapping those shoulders back. Tone your core, take a breath. Try to come out as gracefully as you went in. And release ragdoll. Wiggle your shoulders out and your head out. Deep breath. Full exhale. Release your hands and release behind you. Stretch your knuckles up and stretch your chest and your arms rise all the way up to stand. Reach up. Hands to your heart. Lift and spread your right toes. Come up to the ball of the left foot. Begin to bring your left fingertips down to the inside of your foot. Right hand wraps around to your sacrum. Stretch your chest forward and your tail feathers back. Now you can take this left hand and reach it up towards your sit bone. Perhaps stay right there or bind your arms or use that strap around your hip between your hands. Take a breath in here and a breath out to steady yourself. Stay or find a focal point on the floor and let your gaze follow the floor as you begin to rise. Hug into your belly and lift that left leg away from the earth. Maybe stay, maybe extend a little bit or a lot. I can't extend at all on the slide today. Take one more breath. And again, coming out as gracefully as you went in, or merely collapsing in a puddle on the floor is fine too. And unwind your arms. Shake your arms up. Find a little rag girl. Empty out your head. Fingertips to the floor. Lift your heart. Heel toe your feet and find squat pose here. So coming to some softer, slower in poses now to complete our practice today. Fingertips down, lift your hips, bring yourself back to a table pose on your mat. Extend your right leg and step through to a pigeon pose, right knee a little bit wider than your wrist. Wiggle back through your left toes so your leg is down alongside of your mat. Squeeze your inner thighs together to find some balance here in a very imbalanced pose. And drop your forearms to the floor. Slow down, maybe bring your thumbs or a block to the bridge of your nose. Let your head rest. Bring the palms of your hands back to the mat. Roll your weight off onto your right hip. And I'm going to switch so you can see what I'm doing here. I'm not mirroring now either. So extend your left leg and bring the sole of your right foot into your thigh. Draw the flesh away from your seat. Bring your fingertips behind your right hip and reach your left arm up. And begin to sweep your heart out over your long leg, maybe taking a little twist. Inhale, sweep out. And exhale, sweep across. And one more time, inhale, sweep out. Perhaps finding this modified wild thing, lift your hips, lift your heart. Take a deep breath here. And an easy release coming back to the earth. Bring your right shin parallel to the front of your mat and fold the left shin on top, finding Agnista Baksana Firewall Pose. Draw the flesh away from your seat. If you need a block underneath this knee, if there's a lot of space, bring a block in. Take a breath in, folding your hands to the soles of your feet, reach your chest forward. Find a few complete breaths here. Slowly begin to rise, unwind your legs, and give them a little wiggle. If you have the time to stay in that posture for a little longer, I highly recommend it. But we'll come into pigeon pose on the other side. Find your table and extend your left leg. Bring your knee a little bit wider than your wrist and sneak back through your right leg. Leg is down the long edge of your mat. Squeeze your inner thighs together, draw your belly in, and bring yourself towards the floor. Again, probably placing a block underneath your forehead or maybe bringing the thumbs to the third eye region. Find some softness here. Deep breaths in and out. Come back to that space of gratitude. Gratitude for what has been. Counting your blessings and knowing what needs to be shed, to let go of as we move into the next season. Take another long breath in and out. Slowly rise up onto the palms of your hands. And we'll begin to turn, so bringing the left hip to the floor, right leg long. Fold the sole of your left foot in towards your inner thigh. Bring your left fingertips behind you and stretch your right arm up. And as you exhale, sweep across that long leg, take a little twist. Inhale, sweep it back, right arm rises. And exhale, bring it across for a twist. Last time, inhale, maybe lift the hips, lift the heart this time, modified wild thing. And slowly release everything back to the earth. Bring your left shin parallel to the front edge of your mat and fold the ankles and knees together. In fire log pose, draw the flesh away from your seat. Sit tall, fold the hands to the soles of your feet, and lean your heart forward. Deep breaths in and out. Soften where you can. Let go of any muscle energy here. Take one more long breath in and out. Slowly begin to rise and slowly extend your legs. Give your legs a little shake. And again, drawing the flesh arms up and lead with your heart for a moment. Bring your fingertips down, take a breath. Either stay here if your back is super cranky today, keep yourself long. Otherwise, possibly finding a softer shape, maybe folding the forearms on tops of the legs, or again, bringing thumbs to third eye. Maybe stacking blocks and allowing your forehead to come down to those blocks. Let this evolve, let it be a little wiggly. And stay for a few breaths. Begin to slowly rise up. Fold your legs into easy seat. Place the thumb of your right hand on your right nostril, the fourth finger on your left. Tap your second and third fingers to your third eye. And begin to breathe in and out without pressing on either nostril. Close the left nostril, inhale through the right nostril, and exhale through your right nostril. Inhale right, close right, open left, exhale left. Inhale left, close left, open right, exhale right. Inhale right, close right, open left, exhale left. Inhale left, close left, open right, exhale right. Take two more rounds of nadi shodhana breath to your own pacing. Release your hands into your lap, folding one on top of the other, palms turned up in diagonal mudra. Step head over heart over hips. Long spine, shoulders hug the back of the heart. Come back to that space of gratitude, blessings, harvest. Fold your hands to heart center. Thank you so much for sharing this all levels practice with me. A little bit of yang and a little bit of yin. Hoping to find some balance in your body. Between the energies of dark and light, may you always come out in the light. In gratitude to each of you. Namaste.